continue our coverage this morning remembering the life and legacy of William Donald Schaefer. Joining me now, his former spokesman, Mike Golden, a confidant and friend of the governor's. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
It's been quite a week. I mean, quite a number of wonderful tributes.
It's been wonderful. It's actually been very gratifying to see that he's getting the recognition he so richly deserves and always has deserved for some time. Unfortunately, a lot of times that doesn't happen until after you're gone. But I think he's up there somewhere looking down, smiling.
I think people are really getting a glimpse of the William Donald Schaefer that they didn't really understand now. I mean, they knew him as sort of brash sometimes, and he wanted to get things done. What do you think is coming out now about him?
Well, his public persona was, as you said, brash and irascible. But privately, and I think this is what's coming out, is that he was a very kind and generous man. He was very sweet and very solicitous of me and all the staff about how we were doing, how our families were doing. And it was genuine. It was, you know, he genuinely cared about us. In fact, he used to admonish us if we went on vacation not to take 1 week off, to take 2 weeks off. I mean, he'd really get angry with you if you only took 1 week off, because he said that you need a full 2 weeks to fully, you know, regenerate yourself and come back. And, you know, who has bosses like that?
And it's interesting that you say that, because he didn't have a family of his own in terms of a biological family of his own. Why do you think, you know, he never made time for that?
I think he was so wedded to public service, as corny as that may sound and as cynical as we all seem to be in this day and age. He genuinely cared about all of us. I don't mean just the people that work for him, but, you know, you and the citizens of Baltimore and the citizens of this state. And it was a 24/7 job for him, and he doted on all of us like we were his kids and his family. I always likened him as my favorite uncle.
We've heard so many wonderful stories. Tell us one that we haven't heard yet.
Well, I don't know how funny this is to you, but I thought it was rather funny. When I worked at the state health department, we had a vaccination day to promote vaccinations of our pets for rabies. And we had this event scheduled down at the old Montgomery Wards building down near Carroll Park. Well, he had Willie then. It was his first black lab, and Willie was about a year old. And the lab and his trainer shows up. And the trainer, who's a state trooper, puts Willie through his paces, you know, sit Willie, walk Willie, roll over Willie, sit up, you know, dance, whatever. And the dog did everything that trooper told him to do. Governor Schaefer shows up. He takes the lead from the trooper, and the dog is jumping all around, wouldn't pay any attention to him, and Schaefer was getting really mad. So here he is, the governor of the state of Maryland, and the dog wouldn't pay attention to him.
The dog wouldn't listen to
him.
That's pretty good. All right, so this week, so many wonderful things are planned. Tomorrow, the citizens of in Annapolis, we start out in Annapolis, where he lies in state.
Right, about 10 o'clock, he will lie in state. In the rotunda of the State House from 10 to 2. That'll be open to the public. There will be a short ceremony in the beginning where Governor O'Malley receives the governor. And then at 2 o'clock, Governor Schaefer will leave the State House for the last time, head north to Baltimore. Final destination is the rotunda of City Hall. But before he gets to City Hall, there will be what we're calling the final tour of the city. That'll be between 3 and 5 o'clock. And I think there are 14 locations he's supposed to go by of significance to his life and his career. And he'll lie in state at the rotunda until 9 o'clock that night. That's open to the public. All day Tuesday from 9 to 9 p.m., open to the public. And then Wednesday, the funeral service at Old St. Paul's Church at 11 o'clock, followed by interment at Delaney Valley Memorial Gardens.
Going out in the kind, in the style that he would have wanted.
He's going out big.
Thank you, Mike, so much
for
coming in.